At the First United Methodist Church of Germantown, it's 7 o'clock, dinner time.
Did you think we have enough food? I made a lot.
A mother-daughter duo bustles around a buffet-style table setup, tossing salad, repositioning plates. Three families wander in, taking seats at round tables. It's 20 for dinner tonight at the Northwest Interfaith Hospitality Network. One of them is Rachel Falco, the network's executive director.
We don't feed people. They sit and they have dinner and they connect with the families and, you know, their children play with our children and everybody's talking and you really couldn't tell who was the volunteer and who were the families.
Except, of course, that the families are homeless.
The brilliance of this program is it takes people in congregations who care and it puts them up close and connected to these people. It sets the volunteers up as kind of cheerleaders and as a network, a true network.
There's a fragile line, you know? There's a fragile line between what you have and what you can lose.
Devorah Horn-Greenberg is a volunteer. She and daughter Soshi prepared tonight's meal.
They are like us, like people who don't have a home. I mean, they're just kids and they're just families and they have the same desires and needs and values and, you know, they want the same things we want. And that divide just goes away when you're just sitting down having dinner together.
After dinner come activities. Tonight, both children and parents decorate a white tablecloth with markers.
I like it.
Circles. And mommy is just writing words.
You gotta have faith. You gotta have love, and you gotta be strong. Right?
She would know. That's Octavia Lewis, a network success story. Earlier this year, she was homeless. She recalls her first night in the network.
My son just kept, you know, rubbing my face and wiping my tears and saying, "Mommy, why are you crying?" And I'm like, "Because I want to make a better life for you."
Today, Lewis works as a security guard. She's still wearing her uniform, a starched white button-down shirt and no-nonsense navy trousers. Tonight, she's here to offer support to families going through what she once did.
And it's just so real to me because I didn't see it. I wanted to give up every time, you know, it would be a situation where I feel like I don't feel like going to financial budgeting classes. I'd rather go home and sleep. I don't want to go to group therapy. I'd rather go home and sleep. I don't want to go to parenting classes. I'd rather go home to sleep. But at the end of the day, it made me a stronger and a better person.
And it worked. Tonight, Lewis has her own home to go to. At 9 o'clock, the families in the shelter head upstairs to their rooms, converted church offices. This is Ebony Jones and Christian Stone's second night here. They were stranded with their young son in front of an empty storefront in Frankfurt when a concerned passerby slipped them the number for the network. Jones got up the courage to call.
We was in tears, and I just told him what it was and said we really need help, you know, to get back on our feet to, you know, take care of our child. And instantly they just said, "We want to get you out the cold." They came and picked us up, brung us there, welcomed us, fed us, and we've just been here ever since.
Jones works part-time at a nursing home. She's 19. Her boyfriend, Stone, is 20. It's 11 now, bedtime. Morning comes early in the network. Families have to be up and out of the congregation doors by around 7. Jones has tomorrow off work, so the family will spend the day at the network's day center. It's just up Germantown Avenue from the church. The center offers families computer and phone access, meeting with the network's case manager and psychologist. It's where the work of getting back on their feet happens. Jones types things like ultrasound technician schools into Google, while Stone watches inspirational poetry videos on YouTube. Jones moves to the nearby couch and turns on a video for Christian Jr.
Nothing's going to happen to our puppies.
She coaxes him down for a nap. She has much work to do in the coming weeks, but for now, she lies with her son, stroking his head, watching the puppies.
Oh, I wish we weren't having any.